This is a small procedure of mini insulin fixation of PCR. If you see the approaches, it started like this on the left side first. Then if we go right side.
Jignesh bhai, if you stop your video, self video, probably the audio will be clear.
Yes, yes.
Can you stop?
Yes, I will stop. Don't worry.
Yeah. So go ahead now.
So these all three incidents, you can see how we can reduce the morbidity of incision and dissection. Almost we are doing the same dissection, but we are doing in a very delicate way and just directly reach to the fragment and fix the fragment under the vision. So this is the case. This is type 3 avulsion of the PCL. It is totally avulsed from the crater base. And the CT scan showing the fragment size. And that's the approach. So first is a showing that yellow line is a skin incision and blue dotted line is a split inside the gastrocnemius muscle medial head. So we'll split in two parts and the medial half will protect the vessels. So that's the incision, about 1 inch.
Optimize.
Across the optimized carousel.
Okay.
It is showing nicely.
Across the crease, oblique incision, small, cut skin and subcutaneous tissue, and we will reach to the fascia. Now, it is retracted the fascia. Now we can see the muscle covering the fascia. Two retractors are placed after cutting skin and subcutaneous tissue. And now there is a way. So now my knife direction has changed. And I am going along the line of fibers of the gastrocnemius, medial head. And I will release the just fascia and not the muscle. No muscle cut. So it is done. And in the next picture, you can see there is a split between two fibers. So you can just split the fibers between with finger only. Just run your index finger and you will be able to reach there. And once both the fragments are, both the heads of the gastrocnemius are retracted, we can see the popliteal fascia. This is the popliteal fascia, both heads split and retracted. And my artery is palpating the fragment. That is the fragment. And in circle, in center, you can see the picture. And now I'll cut directly on the fragment of fascia, popliteal fascia, with the knife. No blunt dissection here. Because everything will be easily identified and can be detected nicely. And so fascia is cut. And we can see that this is the fragment. Once the fascia is cut, use the suction. So the blood will be sucked and you can elevate the fragment in front of your eyes with the artery forceps. See, I can elevate and reduce. And this is the fragment. Picture.
Yes.
Now, fragment is provisionally fixed with the 1 kVAR eccentrically. So I am leaving the central part of the fragment for the screw placement. And so I just drill the proximal part of the fragment and just push directly fully threaded screw, non-cannulated, about 50 millimeter with the washer. If the fragment is in 2-3 fragments, then I use the spike washer. And that's the closure. And that's screw. I redeem it. Another case, similar case, it will take about 1 minute. Same, you can see the same fragment is there. And type 3 again. And we will just revise a video again. Sorry. I'm cutting the skin up. Little bit larger incision for a demo than the previous one. Same skin subcut cut. And I have marked a round circle where I am going to get a PCL fragment. And at the horizontal line is the crease. Cutting skin and subcutaneous tissue. Which size cut. Now I am separating the fragment muscle fibers with my finger. And you can see inside, there is a popliteal fascia. Deeply. And you can palpate the fragment which is elevated underneath the fascia. Now I'm cutting the fascia over the fragment. my spike will be over the border of the tibia. This is the spike. Where I put the spike? The picture showing the where the spike will be distal to crater. My spike is here. That is in the distal to crater, and I can see the fragment. You can elevate the fragment. See. You can see the fragment clearly with the artery forceps, which is elevated. Now I can reduce it. Put provisional K wire on the side and put a screw.
And that provisional wire also gives you the direction of the screw drilling.
Yeah, you get usually you are oriented, so there won't be any problem. You remain on the top of the fragment to drill. The screw is fixed, and you can see the IITB images. This is the closer. This is a little bit larger incision just to have a better idea. Another one, just case, similar fragment and similar incision is there. The screw, another one, just 30 seconds. Another piece of PCL fragment. These two small incisions are there. And you can see the fragment.
Yes.
See, you can see the fragment in front of your eyes. You can see whole crater. Put a spike distal to that crater. Reduce under vision. Provisional fix with K wire and put a screw. Thank you, sir.
Any reason you are using a fully threaded screw? You feel that probably a partially threaded may not be. It will not be a better option here. You must be giving your reasons.
Yeah. Sir, partially threaded screw has a very less threads at the tip only.
Jignesh bhai, you can switch on your video.
Yeah. Yes, I am doing. I will have to ask him to do. I am doing that.
His video was superb.
Yes, fantastic.
Fantastic.
We could always, we could ourselves palpate the fragment. It was
a good yes.
Exactly.
Yeah. Sir, partially threaded screw has a very few threads at the tip only. And I am not using a bi-cortical screw. So, to have a better purchase, there is a dense cancellous bone in the tibia.
I have sent you a request to start your video. You can start your video.
Yeah. So, to get a better purchase in the subchondral bone of the tibia, of the screw, I use fully threaded screw. As I am drilling the proximal portion, it works as almost like a lag screw. And it presses the fragment very well. And we have done a number of cases and none of the screws backed out.
Jignesh, when yes, you sir. Have a larger fragment.
Yeah, you can use two screws.
No. Let me complete. When okay. you have a larger fragment and where it goes towards the center of the tibia.
Yeah.
That means anteriorly.
Yeah.
Now, your trajectory of the screw is such, it is posterior.
Yeah.
Okay. So, when you tighten it, it will open anteriorly.
Yeah.
So, in those situations, what do you do?
Sir, if the fragment is very large and you cannot see the completely fragment, then I will open a little bit more. I will see the complete fragment, press it anteriorly when I put the screw posteriorly.
Okay. And how many times you have used a plate, additional plate to have a purchase on that?
Sir, when the fragment is very big and it is going on the posterior column, posterior cortex also.
Okay.
Then we have used a small buttress plate, 2-hole or 3-hole, like a hook and put it like that, put it down. Okay. Because there is no base to put a screw from the top.
So anti-glide.
Anti-glide plate.
For the information I am asking, I am not sure what it is. Whether the arthroscopists can do the same job with the screw.
Sir, they can do same things. But there are a number of articles saying that it is you need a very, very high level of expertise, one thing. Second thing, time will be more than this procedure. This procedure takes 12 minutes, 12 to 15 minutes only.
That is to Jignesh.
Yes. very small incision. Sir, and third thing will be arthroscopy will not give this type of the compression and reduction of the fragment.
Okay. Jignesh bhai.
That is given in literature, sir. I have no experience.
Yeah.
And Jignesh. Also in literature, anteroposterior screw is also described.
Yeah.
From the anterior cortex to the PCL.
Yeah.
Yes.
So how good is the fixation of that screw?
Sir, you don't need too much stable fixation. This single screw holds the things very well in most of the literature support now. And in latest three articles, after 17, 18 and 19, they all suggest that you use a single one screw with you adequate fixation and optimum outcome in this type of injury.
So, there is no much forces later on.
Yes. There are no active muscles for the acting on this.
Dr. Chandok wants to say something. Yes,
yeah.
Yeah.
Jignesh bhai, when you started using PCL fixations,
yes, sir.
You must have opened by a good incision posteriorly.
Sir, first case I did during, after just passing my MS orthopedics in 1994, I did with a large S-shaped incision. Okay. With going between two heads of gastroc nemius, it took me 2 hours and I had a lot of tension of vessel and all these problems. Okay. Gradually, over a period of time, we did more number of cases. Now we have done more than 200 cases. And because of experience and more of an exposure of the posterior medial condyle tibia fracture, I got an idea that this can be done like this.
Okay. So your last 10, 50, 25 cases are mini open.
Yeah, sir. Almost 30, more than 30 cases are mini open now, last 2 years.
And most of the.
Surat mein itna sab cases hota hai.
डॉक्टर के रिलेटिव को उस दिन मीटिंग में इधर था शाम को, उस दिन तुड़वाया टीबीएल कोंडा ही शाम को किया
जिग्नेश भाई,
इसीलिए फ्रैक्चर करवाया उसने।
Jignesh bhai, there is a question from Dr. Mahapatra again. If the fragment is very small, what is your suspect loop?
If the fragment is very small, but the fragment will not be totally free, it will be attached with the fibers of the PCL fragment. PCL. So, what you do, you go through the substance of PCL and use a spike washer and press the fragment under the washer.
Yes.
There will be one more question from Dr. Sahuji about a jig, available jig.
No, that is not a question here, sir.
Naveen bhai.
Fantastic.
Naveen bhai.
Jignesh bhai, fantastic.
Yes, Swapnil, yes, Swapnil, bhai,
Swapnil, by that time, keep your presentation ready.
Swapnil, please. I can see Dr. Dhaval wants to ask.
Dhaval, sir. Yes, sir.
Jignesh, the only problem with this is, suppose you have to take out pull-out stitches.
You get a just little bit longer incision distally. And no, you will be able to see posterior surface of tibia and you can do everything.
Room for maneuvering, a big Achibond needle will be very small over there in that.
Sir, you extend the incision 1 inch more distally and you will get a lot of room for the doing everything. So your incision will become 2 inches or 2.5 inches. That's all.
But again, the approach will be splitting the delta, splitting the gastrocnemius. Not retracting the medial head.
You are extending that same split, I think. You are extending
that. Sir, by and large, you are fixed by your idea that we are going to with this method. So, if you are going to do pull-out scissor and all these methods, then you may just do regular posterior incision and retract the head medially and do it.
Anytime you have to release the medial head?
No, sir.
During this procedure, fragment fixation not.
Okay.
Initially, I used to do like that, larger incision. But then I got an idea that there is too much of the bulk of the muscle to be retracted. So split will make the retraction half and it will take me to the fragment directly.
And so, how many miles you will go to do this approximately?
Yes, sir.
How many miles you go?
you would go if we call you somewhere?
Whether you will go to Bombay to do this?
4 hours.
Sir, anywhere you will call, I will come definitely.
Dhaval bhai, wo jo needle ka bolta hai, itthi bond ki. You use a fiber wire needle that is very sturdy, very small. Yeah, very small and very good. And the fiber wire is stronger than the ethibond.
Yes.
Knotting also is good. Yeah.